SpaceX may be prepping Starship S-24 and Super Heavy Booster 7 for their potential near-orbital launch debut, but the rest of the company's Starship factory is not idle. After completing a difficult fueling test and launch rehearsal earlier this week, SpaceX has set the stage for a record-breaking Starship booster static burn. Welcome to First Class Tech, and in this video, we will see how SpaceX has set the stage for Starship Booster's first 33-engine static fire. On January 25th, a skyscraper-sized tower activated a pair of massive mechanical arms to disassemble the largest rocket ever built. Using firm points under the flaps, the arms cautiously gripped Starship and raised the 50-meter-tall second stage and spaceship off of the Super Heavy Booster 7. The robot, dubbed Mechazilla, lowered the 100-ton car hundreds of feet onto a waiting stand before finally letting go. SpaceX returned Ship 24 to its starbase in Texas plant for finishing touches on January 26. Booster 7 remained on Starbase's donut-shaped orbital launch platform, which employs clamps and umbilicals to hold Starship in place, while also powering, fueling, and pressurizing Super Heavy. In principle, Booster 7 will leave that launch mount on its own power the following time. However, SpaceX must first prove that its enormous power can be controlled. Unfortunately, this is not the first time that this story has been told. Many times, over the last year and a half, SpaceX appeared to be on the verge of reaching the milestone. Elon Musk, for example, claimed in September of 2021 that Super Heavy Booster 4 will attempt the first static fire on Starbase's orbital launch ramp later that month. 11 months later, Super Heavy Booster 7 performed its first static fire test on the OLM. Although with only one of its 33 engines, Booster 7 conducted another single-engine test, a 2-engine test, a 7-engine test, a 14-engine test, and a long-duration 11-engine test in the months following the static fire. All of that calm and steady testing has been quite successful, with no significant damage to the rocket or the pad. However, 5 months in, SpaceX has never ignited more than 14 to 42% of Super Heavy's 33 Raptor engines at the same time. This must happen before SpaceX can have enough faith in Starship to attempt an orbital launch. The booster may have delivered up to 3,220 tons of thrust during Super Heavy B7's 14-engine static fire when all 33 usable engines are activated for the first time. Its maximum thrust might reach 7,590 tons, outperforming the next most powerful rocket in history, the Soviet N1, by approximately 60%. In other words, SpaceX will attempt something unparalleled in the history of rocketry. Success is far from guaranteed, and the worst-case failure mode may nearly completely destroy Starship's only completed orbital launch site, prompting SpaceX's extreme caution. Ship 24 and Booster 7 accomplished Starship's first full wet dress rehearsal on the first try on January 23rd, an exceedingly astounding feat for any rocket, let alone the largest in history. After that combination test, the only thing standing between Starship and its maiden orbital launch attempt is a 33-engine Super Heavy static fire. Ship 24 was removed from Booster 7 to decrease danger. Back at the factory, SpaceX will need to repair a few breaches in the heat shield and will most likely perform thorough inspections to guarantee that the Starship is ready for takeoff. Booster 7, now free of Ship 24, may be on the verge of the most difficult ground test in Starship and SpaceX history. SpaceX has arranged 12-hour road closures for January 30th, 31st, and February 1st, which could be used for this reason. The factory's laser focus on meticulously testing Ship 24 and Booster 7 may have hampered the factory's efficacy, but it has continued to build new ships and boosters. SpaceX has even performed limited testing on a pair of prototypes that are intended to follow in the footsteps of S-24 and B-7. That procedure reached a new and more active phase in mid-January when SpaceX carried Starship S-25 from the factory to the launch pad. This is not Ship 25's first journey. Starship S-25 was delivered to SpaceX's South Texas launch and testing facilities on October 19th of 2022, immediately after it was completed. By the way, if you're watching us for the first time, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you can enjoy our future videos while getting updated. Now coming back to the topic. Following 3 weeks of testing, Ship 25 has returned for more. The first round of tests included a pneumatic proof test, various cryogenic proof tests, and maybe a few simulated thrust tests utilizing 6 hydraulic ramps. The following 2 tests were most likely conducted on the customized test stand, which has been semi-permanently outfitted with a set of hydraulic ramps that allow SpaceX to simulate the thrust of 6 Raptor engines, while the Starship structures are chilled to cryogenic temperatures and loaded with approximately 1,000 tons of cryogenic fluids. If a Starship can withstand those loads on the ground, it is assumed that it can withstand equivalent stresses in flight. SpaceX would not comment on the development or indicate how the initial proof testing went, but Ship 25's return to the launch site on January 14th of 2023 all but guaranteed that the testing went as planned. Ship 25 was lifted onto Starbase's single Starship static fire test stand on January 17th, proving that Ship 25 proof testing went as planned. 6 Raptor engines were carried into the high bay and installed on Ship 25 shortly after its November 2022 return to Starbase's manufacturing site. Before heading to the test site to begin its static fire test campaign, the Starship's aft was most likely sealed with a heat shield. This campaign could reveal a lot about the current state of Starship prototypes. Only 2 ships have conducted full 6 Raptor static fire tests to yet, and both took days, weeks, or months to build up to those 6 engine milestones through a series of smaller tests. If Ship 25 skips those preliminary tests and instead conducts a 6 engine static fire, it would indicate that SpaceX is far more confident in the current Starship design. Ship 25 is thought to be partnered with Super Heavy Booster 9, which has just completed its own round of proving testing. Booster 9 rolled out of its Starbase assembly bay around 2 months after Ship 25 and traveled to the launch location on December 15th of 2022. On December 21st and 29th, the Super Heavy prototype underwent 2 partial cryogenic proof tests, during which it was likely loaded with 1,000 tons of liquid nitrogen to imitate explosive liquid oxygen and methane propellant. On January the 10th of 2023, Booster 9 returned to Starbase's manufacturing. Outfitting and testing this Super Heavy may take longer than usual due to considerable design alterations and enhancements featured on Booster 9. There are numerous minor updates, but the most noteworthy by far is the addition of an updated version of Raptor. The engine's combustion-related hardware is most likely the same as that found in Booster 7, Ship 24, and Ship 25 Raptor V2 engines. However, the technology required to drive each engine, known as thrust vector control, has been substantially redesigned. Instead of a complex labyrinth of plumbing and hydraulic power units mounted to the side of Super Heavy, Booster 9's 13 central Raptors will be directed electronically. SpaceX will need to ensure that the batteries that will presumably power those new systems work as predicted. The electric TVC may need to swiftly redirect more than 3,000 tons of force several times per second under the highest pressures that will most likely experience. As a result, the peak power required from Super Heavy's batteries will almost certainly be enormous. For the time being, Super Heavy B9's static fire test campaign will have to wait until Starbase's lone orbital launch mount, which is now occupied by Booster 7, Ship 24, and Starship's first orbital launch campaign, is vacated. With an orbital launch debuted unlikely until March of 2023, Booster 9 will have plenty of time to relax inside Starbase's wide bay while Ship 25 conducts static fire testing at a different stand. Those road closures could be employed instead of, or in addition, to Booster 7 static fire testing for Ship 25. It is unknown whether static fire testing can be performed without the HPU, why it was removed, or how long will it take to replace it, adding to the uncertainty. Nonetheless, it appears that SpaceX is only a few weeks away from attempting Starship's first 33-engine static fire. And with that being said, it is time to end our video. Before that, we would like to know, what are your thoughts on this static fire? Let us know in the comments. Like this video and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos like this one. We will see you in the next video.